So last night we slept in Columbus and we drove 40 minutes to Buena Vista.
It was a drive and we didn't see any cars the whole drive. It's very remote here. We're at
Pasacuan,
I guess. Founder of this area is Sint EOM. And that stands for Eddie Owen Martin. I had a vision a long time ago, yep. And the humans from the future came to him in that vision and told him about Pasacuan, and that's unity or a mecca of understanding, togetherness and art. He told him about that place back in the day. He was in New York and they say, well, go to Georgia and go
do something.
So he made this place up. It's a psychedelic place, 6 buildings on 7 acres of ground. Well, the buildings are well decorated with murals and everything you see is colorful. How we like it.
He started building it in 1955. He was getting his money for funding these buildings with the fortune-telling gigs.
So he must be very good at it.
Yeah.
Because he made a lot of buildings with that money.
It was 6 buildings. The land is 7 acres per
Yeah, so big. It's kind of big. Yeah. Poor guy took his life in 1986.
So
he had enough of it.
Place left unfinished by then.
Yeah, that's kind of bad. But after a while, because of the rain, the murals were getting down and disintegrated. But there was a foundation called the Pasacuan
Preservation Society.
Yeah, they will preserve it, and now it's on a historical monument.
Historic landmark.
So it will be like this forever and ever. And we saw on the sign on the side of the road that it's property from the Columbus University. So they help preserve
here.
This place.
Let's check it out, guys.
Yeah.
This is the oratory, or the inner circle. This is where Eddie meditated or made music. He didn't invite a lot of people here, but he liked sometimes, on occasion, to perform for people and make music.
This space is the workshop. Here he made his furniture and all his art. It was packed with all kinds of tools. You can't see it now, but it was a big workshop. Not finished yet. Look. As we just told yesterday, we slept in Columbus at the Walmart and we saw a little black boy, sorry, he was black, I can't help it, stopping, putting his bike to the side, and he was walking to the back of our van, and we were like, well, he's just playing there or talking with his friends. But now we noticed something missing. The little bastard took my saddle. Now I can't bike anymore, so I have to buy a new one. That's a bummer.
It is even be touted as one of the state's 7 natural wonders, which is totally weird, because the canyon is not only far from a natural, its creation was more blunder than wonder. Those exquisitely huge sediment walls are a product of inexperienced farmers making a colossal mess of things, and Mother Nature has kind of worked around it from there.
In 1800, people had a love to learn about soil management, as you can see behind us. Plowing left deep furrow when left unmanaged, became deeper and wider due to the rain and the wind. And the furrows became ravines, and the ravines became canyons, like this one. Man's mistake became cynical panorama of natural beauty. We've reached the bottom of the canyon. There are several hiking trails. The red trail is 7 miles and the white trail is 2.5 miles. But we wanted to do a part of the red trail because then you stay on the bottom of the canyon. And I think it's awesome to stand on the bottom and to see the big walls of the nice walls. So let's check it out.
Unfortunately, some people think it's necessary to tag or carve the names into the canyon here in the sand or most likely stone. More like a dog who is peeing his mark his territory.